Hello and welcome to the Notepad++ tutorial. In this tutorial you're going to learn how to set up, download Notepad++ and set it up on your computer and then connect it to your server in order to be able to edit PHP files, HTML files, CSS files and more. So the first thing you want to do is go to the Google search engine and type in Notepad++. You want to go to notepad++.org. Next thing you want to do is click download. You'll get this little window right here. Just click download, Notepad installer, and it will download to your computer in a matter of seconds. After Notepad++ installer has downloaded, click on the little icon and you want to allow this program to make changes on your computer. Next, you'll select English and then you will just keep clicking next. You have to agree to the terms and you can change your destination folder. I'm going to change my destination folder since I already have Notepad++. I'm just going to put plus in there, but you do not have to do that, or you can browse to a different folder. Since I already have it installed on my machine, I'm going to install it in this directory so I can walk you through the rest of the process. I'm going to leave all the default items selected. Click next. Leave all of these as default. If you want a shortcut on your desktop, you can tick this box and it will put a shortcut on your desktop. I'm going to leave it unticked since I already have a previous installation. It will download all the stylers and modules and stuff that you need for Notepad++ to work and to connect via FTP to your server in order to edit your files. After it has recorded everything, it's going to give you the option to run Notepad++ immediately. We will go ahead and click finish and it will fire up Notepad++ for us, and you can see that it's ready to go. Now it fired up my Notepad++. Yours would probably look something like this, with text being written across the top of it from its programmer. Okay. The thing that you want to keep make sure of is that you show this, go to plugins, the NPP FTP window, click show the window, and here whenever you're connected to a server you'll be able to browse the files on the server, download them, edit them, and as soon as you click save it will upload it to the server. The other thing that you would want to keep in mind that I use quite a bit, if I go to plugins and here's my Explorer window, I can hit explore just like this and this shows the files on my current computer. So I could take these files from my current computer and edit them as well. Okay, so those are the two main things that you want to keep in mind, and they're located under this plugins tab. Okay, so let's say that you wanted to edit a website. Alright, I'm going to show you how to set up a file transfer protocol in your cPanel on your website. You should have received this information from whoever your host provider is. That is the cPanel login information. You may have Parallels Plesk or something else of that nature, but the process is going to be similar. The website that I will use to demonstrate the capabilities of Notepad++ is going to be DJWH. And if you go to this website right here, djwh.com, usually to access the cPanel, you just put /, type in cPanel, just like that. And it will connect to the cPanel. And you can see that I already have my username and password to log into my cPanel. If you don't have this information, you will have to contact your hosting provider to get it. Once you log in, you're going to scroll down. We'll click no, fine, I'm fine, thanks, but you're going to look for FTP accounts, okay? So what we want to do is click on FTP accounts, and we're going to create an FTP login so we can log in with Notepad++. So we'll type in Maximus at DJWH. I will give a password. Retype that password in. Now, this is very important that you understand that this is going to create another directory called Maximus, but I don't want it to create another directory. I want to access the main directory, which is public underscore HTML. I'm going to give myself unlimited access and create the FTP account. That is all I have to do to create an FTP account. Now I'll just go to the main part of the website, DJWH, and hit enter, and you can see the content that I have on here now. Now I'm going to fire up my Notepad++. I'm going to go to my Plugins tab. I'm going to scroll down to my NPP FTP and have it show that window for me. I'm going to click on Settings, Profile Settings, and I'm going to click Add New. Okay, now I'm going to add a new profile, and I'm just going to call this DJD for DJWH, and then I'm going to click OK. The next thing I'm going to do is then enter DJWH.com into here. Now, here, the other thing that I would tell you is that you can also use an IP address. So if you know the IP address to the website, you can actually use that in there. And so then we want to type in our username, just like an email address, maximus@djwh.com, and then the password that you set up for the FTP. And then you want to hit your enter button. Now, what I'm going to do is you click on this little plug here and you scroll down to DJD, and it will connect to the server. Now you can see the files that are on the server. If you double click this file and bring it down to the editor, you can see that the content that we have on there. Just to show you how this works, we'll put an H1 tag in here and we'll put welcome to DJWH. And then we're going to hit Control S on our keyboard and upload that to the server just like that. And then we'll go ahead and navigate our way to the server and refresh. Now let's say I wanted to add another file onto that server. All I would have to do is right click and click Create New File. And maybe I'll give it like upcoming shows. .html and then hit enter. You see now the file is then created on the server. If I double click this file and download it to the editor, you can see that it is a blank document. Now that I have the blank document, I can very easily just go to my index.html and copy this all and insert it into here and change the text. Or I can get my little snippets plugin. Let me go ahead and see if I can find it real quick here for you. So if you want to install a plugin in Notepad++, you go to Plugins Manager, Show Plugins Manager, and it's going to download a list. Okay, and then it'll have the things that need to be updated and the things that are installed. So the particular plugin that I'm interested in is the snippet plugin. And if I come down here, I'm looking for snippets, snippet plus, snippets. I'll just go ahead and install them both. And now it's going to download that from the web server. And so, and then it'll say some installation steps still need to be completed. Notepad++ needs to be restarted in order to complete these steps. So we could go ahead and restart Notepad++ now so we could take advantage of our code snippets plugin. So you'll get a little notification here. You could just click close. Now you're going to see a lot of snippets here. But the particular snippet that I want is in the snippets plus. And here you can select your different types of programming styles, and we want to select HTML. I'm going to scroll down here to where it says HTML, and instead of entering all that code by hand, I just simply double click this and it puts all the code in there for me, and I'm ready to go. So I could give this a title, upcoming shows, just like that. And then I could come over here and grab an H1 tag and say Shows soon to come. And then I could go on the end of that tag and scroll down here and maybe make something with bold text, don't miss it. Something like that. And then I hit save. And then I could go back to DJ Double H. And what I want to do is hit forward slash and check the file upcoming shows dot HTML, I believe is what we named it. Shows soon to come. Don't miss it. And so that's your little tutorial on how to use Notepad++ to upload files via FTP to your server. Okay, so, and if you want to hide these things and you just want to see your FTP window, you can go here. And then here's all the action and progress down here as you download and upload files. So this was a short little tutorial on how to use Notepad++ to edit files on your server. You could edit any kind of file, PHP, CSS, HTML, JavaScript, and more.